The Oracle ASMR. Okay. I'm not gonna lie. I'm scared. Okay. Seriously. I have to ask, is this gonna hurt? The teleporting. It's obviously not something I've ever experienced before, but this does terrify me a little. I mean, I'm excited. I am. And I'm interested to know how this works, but at the same time, I am just scared. Okay. I really don't get where we go, but all I ask is that we just get there in one piece. I know this is on you, but right, so we just have to link hands, right? Okay. Okay. Alright. Alright. I think I'm as ready as I'll ever be. It's a bit of a role reversal here. Okay, I have complete and utter trust in you. Take it away. Let's teleport. People. I'm pretty sure that they don't have that. Are we even in the same time? You don't know where we are, do you? That's worrying. In fact, just be honest with me. You're lost, right? It looks like we're not. I would ask someone, but I can't believe this, but I don't think we're in the same time. Did you travel back in time? No, forward. You've gone to the future. How? No. What's this? What is this? So, I don't think you've gone back or forward. Okay, I'm gonna need a minute to process this because it's the same date. This looks similar, but not. Like a deja vu, like I've been here before, maybe. I recognize some of it, but then I don't come to think of it. If you've done what I think you've done, then you were opened up so many questions, and you're even more amazing than I thought. I think you've just teleported to a different dimension. I can't be sure, but I'm sure if I check with the nanos, they might be able to transmit some of this. The frequency would obviously be different. I wonder if this will even be recorded, technically speaking. Probably not, because if we're in a different dimension, oh my god, can you? Do you know how to go back? No. Alright, that's... Right, not freaking out. Not freaking out. Alright, I'm freaking out a little bit. You know, not that I didn't want to experience something like this. I did, after all, want to teleport with you, but this... I kind of thought that you would, stay in our reality. I'm not blaming you. I am just a little bit concerned that we might be stuck here. And wow, this place looks quite interesting, actually. I would love to find out more about this place, but I do want to go back. I want to go back to our world, please. Yes, you do too. Well, that's a start. Yeah, you're gonna be fine. Look, I have an idea. I know of only one person who, at the time, had stories about what you've just done. Traveling to different dimensions, and to be fair, they were stories, so I don't think anyone really took them seriously, but now I guess I can see that there may have been truth to those stories. I really need to apologize to Raven. Yes, that's the first thing I'll do as soon as we get back to Raven. It's okay, it's alright. So, what I'd like you to do is think of Raven. I know you're gonna be able to do this. I know, and it's totally normal to be feeling a little drained and weak. You're bound to have a headache too. Because I know it's probably taking you a lot just to gather enough energy to come here. I mean, the power that you must be spending right now. Look, I don't think you probably have enough to do that again. So, I'm gonna show you how, but I think you're gonna need to take some of my pills. It's okay. It's a procedure that we can do, and normally you have time to practice, but I don't think we have much time anymore. Oh, this place looks like homeless. I don't think we should stay here very long. I don't think we should. The only things I know about their mentions are that you can, with the shift of us being here, we can change a lot if we do things, if we speak to people. We should probably just get back and we'll speak to Raven. So, I'll show you how the procedure works in us connecting with each other, with our forces. The way this works is by me opening myself to you so that you can receive my power, my energy. I have to be willing to give it, as you have to be willing to receive it. And it's really not that difficult, but it's the other stuff that's difficult, the giving and receiving part. Because it won't work unless you really, deep down, 100% want it. So, look, what we need to do is close your eyes, take my hands, okay, and I want you to just breathe with me, and we're going to do this until we're breathing together, nice deep breaths, just like I showed you with the meditation. And then once we're doing that, you're gonna feel my heartbeat. It's gonna sound louder and louder as our connection builds. And as the energy passes from me to you, you're gonna feel it. It's gonna be like a warmth, a tingly feeling, and it will sort of start. Maybe the back of your head, right down your neck, into your back, and right down your lower back. And that tingly sensation may last a while, but once you feel that, you will be able to use my energy and power. And when you feel that sensation, I want you to think of Raven. Think of Raven's apartment. Think of the smells that you remember. Think of Raven's voice, presence. And think of wanting to be there. And I'm pretty sure that that will be enough to get us back. Raven will know what to do, and I think we'll need Raven's help, because this is going to drain us. It will drain me, but it will also drain you, and I think we'll need Raven's ability to restore us. So it's best we go back there first. We'll be okay. I promise. I really do have faith that we can get back. It's okay. It's okay to be scared. But we're in this together, right? Of course. I trust you. Alright, let's do this. So we're gonna do the breathing. We made it.
You are getting very used to coming here.
It's okay.
Unannounced.
I know, Raven. None of this was planned.
These are not organized visits.
We'll talk about that later, but... As you can see,
but as it seems that this one is somewhat different. Perhaps this is coded desperation. I see.
Yes, we need your
many
help.
Things, in fact. What is this?
Exactly.
The consciousness of this one.
Stay with me.
Is far beyond normal levels. You. This one has the third
eye. Right. Come on, Raven,
you're gonna find.
Yes, we take it to another dimension. I don't know how it's possible.
How is it possible?
I don't know.
It is possible when the human understands the yin and the yang.
We've had this discussion before.
The physical.
It still doesn't explain.
And the virtual.
The dimensional.
Interstellar communication and travel. These things are very much possible. As you know, thought is so powerful. Our minds are powerful.
Yeah.
And if we truly understand consciousness, if we truly can distinguish between endless possibilities. Yes. I see now. I was right. Submergence was but a stepping stone.
I see.
This one was already built. Dimensional understandings of this universe. You are constricted by the physical universe. When you finally open yourself to the virtual world is like the invisible electric impulse full of powers unimaginable.
It kind of makes sense, I guess.
Do you think enhance your own when you remove the physical constraints? You are able to travel to what is not there, but what is there intended. No, you will not see. You will not understand. Maybe not yet. You are not ready. When you are ready for the virtual world that lies within all of us, the capabilities, but
that still opens up so many questions.
This one is not only awake, but is no longer constricted. This one has created the geometric balance, the yin and the yang.
I knew you'd have answers, sir.
You have done what I have done, what has taken me centuries. You are far more powerful than I. I will explain another time. It seems that this one needs a boost. You are drained. Yes, I can see you are drained. Your body is but human. It is your physical form. After all,
you must
tend to this body as needed. You are right to bring this one here. I will care for this one. I will care for this one until the energies are back.
Thanks, Raven. Appreciate it.
Fool. I am sure they can hear. Your agent will be here with you, I am sure, by your side. Do not be afraid, for I now see that you are with me. You are very much alive. You are neither light or dark. Is enough for now. You are neither enemy. No. Rest, I will provide you with some tea.
Much appreciated.
Raven special tea.
My favorite. I can't wait.
Your agent will hold your hand and give you a drip, like a hospital drip. A hospital drip is giving you nutrients to regain necessary things that you need. Your agent will trickle her powers into you to supply you with what you are now missing. You will feel better, but my tea will suffice and give you the boost that you need for your physical and for You must never over exert yourself like this again. No. For moments like this should be very few and far in between. It is dangerous. And you can only take so much. Your agent will need some replenishment too, so you will stay here with me.
I knew you'd be able to help right
here. Yes. Good. Now, rest. I will take good care of this one. As for you, you too must rest. You can lay next to them. They can hear. However, they will remain unconscious for the duration. This is best, as it is comfortable for you both.
Thank you.
Simply relax. I will do what I can for you. And then we will discuss all there is. For now,